Hey guys, welcome to another video. A new update has been released for Tears of the Kingdom. According to the patch notes, these were the changes implemented. Nothing performance related. Issues were fixed in the audio, in the main quest, and others related to gameplay. Several websites have reported that the recent patch was deployed to address and counteract the item duplication glitch exploited by players. I will be testing the latest version of the game on the Yuzu emulator, specifically in its early access version 3615. I have successfully configured the emulator to run the game at 60 FPS without relying on any specific mods. Allow me to guide you through the process. Here are the updated mods available for the new version of the game. The first mod significantly enhances the graphics quality, while the second mod ensures that the game maintains a compatible speed with the frame rate without any acceleration or deceleration. To achieve this desired outcome, here are the essential settings you need to configure. Recommend this resolution in docked mode to keep graphics in high quality. Now, we'll show you how to change the frame rate without using mods and without the need to restart the game. You just need to change the percent speed limit that was at 200 to 100. That's all, it's possible to play now at 30 FPS. It's the frame rate I recommend for low-end PCs. It is now possible to play at a smooth frame rate without stuttering or crashes. But if your PC is high-end, I recommend 60 FPS, it will be very smooth too. Just change it to 200%. My PC is old, I can only maintain this frame rate in the game menus. The frame rate is very unstable on my PC, ranging from 30 to 50 FPS. Now I'm going to show you the performance with and without reshade. This post-processing injector greatly improves the graphics quality. You can see here on my monitor that the GPU usage is at 70%. Now with reshade off, usage drops to 53%. That's why I recommend using reshade. With it, we can use the full potential of our GPU. With it on, I didn't lose performance, the frame rate remains the same, the emulator is completely CPU bound, so I can't reach 60 FPS. This is the screen where we activate the effects that we are going to use with the reshade. See here the activated effects. I will demonstrate to you how smooth the game is with the stable frame rate when we lock in 30 FPS. Okay, follow this part of the gameplay with me. Thank you so much to watch this video. If you liked what you saw, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I really appreciate your support and it helps me to keep creating new content for you guys. I hope you'll join me on this journey and stay tuned for more.